Welcome to the video edition of NetFront Presence. I'm Jeff Gordon with Ben Frederickson, and boy, the series took a turn in Dallas. Now it's tied 2-2. The Stars had a big push. Coach Jim Montgomery wanted his top guys to push forward to reach a new level. They did. So now guess what? The Blues have to respond in Game 5.
Yeah, they did, and the Blues got their licks in. They got their pushes and their tough guy talk, but unfortunately it didn't lead to a win. So they've kind of got to remember what the point of these games are. Now, so the Stars are flopping left and right. It looks like the NBA playoffs out there. I know it makes fans back here crazy, especially when the announcers are you know, convinced these flops are mean something and that they actually are in pain. It's wild to watch. But the Blues have to not let that distract them from their game. You know, they've got to put the clamps on that top line like they did against Winnipeg, or else this series is going to go from tied to, you know, over in Dallas's favor in a hurry.
Now, you look at some of the stuff that was going on. I mean, Ben Bishop went down as if that was a medieval poleaxe, something perhaps you'd see in Game of Thrones. It wasn't quite that severe, but it is a spirited series, and certainly Dallas did start pushing to play. The key for the Blues, broadly speaking, you've got to attack and not react, and they were just reacting and chasing the game. Instead of pushing the game and pushing the pace, they were chasing the game. And then three things, Ben, Fred, in hockey. It's very simple. Get it out, get it deep, and shoot the puck. Quit turning it over coming out of your zone. Quit turning it over in the middle of the ice going into their zone. And for the God's sakes, don't pass up a clean look. Dallas is very good at blocking shots, very good defensively and back checking. Get a shot, take a shot. And, you know, Robert Thomas.
I was going to say, that's one guy who followed that example. Yeah, he shoots and scores last night. It's funny how that works.
And the game before he shot, the bleeder through, and Bozak finished it for him. But, yeah, he's one guy. Assert yourself, Robert Thomas. A big story in Game 4.
Who needs to step it up? You mentioned Robert Thomas is a guy who has stepped up, and his play has been outstanding. He's fast, and really, I think you watch him and say, man, he's so young. This is such a promising postseason for him, not just this season, but beyond. Who's somebody that you're looking at that says, this guy's got to be better?
Well, you look at that whole line with Maroon and Bozak. That's great. That's your third group. That's valuable. Now, let's look at Ryan O'Reilly. In the faceoff circle, he's not been the dominant guy that he was much of the season. That's a matchup. The Stars have done well in the faceoff circle. You need that top line going, and certainly moving Schwartz and juggling pieces around, they were hoping to get there. At even strength, that line's got to be better. Your second line with Perron and the Shen's got to be better. So really, you want to have your depth take over. You want to have your top three lines all going. However you configure, however you adjust on the fly, I think that's still an advantage for the Blues over Dallas. We've seen Jim Montgomery shuffle things around to get more depth in his attack. The Blues have that depth. They just have to get the results.
Get it engaged. And one thing about Ryan O'Reilly, I think he may have had a goal that wasn't counted in that last game. I don't know. I would have loved to see the overhead crossbar angle on that. I guess the replay office was too busy, you know, determining the severity of the flopping to check out that goal. But like to see him get going. You have to have some production from him. And Vladimir Tarasenko, too. He's great on the power play. Where is he everywhere else? So that will be kind of the storylines headed back into the game, the series, as it shifts back here to St. Louis at a tie.
Yeah, it's such a pivotal time. You win that game. Now you've got the edge. You lose that game. Now you're chasing the Stars. They're going home. They're feeling great. We could be back next week talking about the next series, or we could be back next week putting this team in its grave. So, Ben, Fred, until next time, this has been the video edition of NetFront Presence.